Hello and welcome back to France. Last time we ended it with basically just a fabrication of claim on these guys. We'll be claiming the throne right now, and we'll be declaring war basically as soon as we can. And with this, we will be, well, being mean to them, I guess you could say. But all in all, it simply is about getting a lot of promises free. Lübeck to Booth is also very a very rich one. So taking these guys in this manner is more than enough for me. I'm happy with it. Also, apparently we don't really have anything to use our administrative points to, so we'll go ahead and boost it to. I'm actually tempted to boost it a little bit longer, but we'll keep it at one. So we'll try and keep it at one. That'll be the main goal here. And I probably going for this war is probably the best move I could make. When I think about stuff, but still, it's only Holstein and Burgundy, so I don't really have that many men. So splitting this army up and simply using it for sieges is probably the best thing I can do right now. We'll keep the 3,000 men in Lübeck. We'll simply split these guys up, have them siege wherever I can, and we'll use these guys to hunt down the two Holstein guys. We'll put these guys on siege duty. And all in all, it's basically siege or kill that everyone will be doing. So, without any further ado, we'll simply put everything on siege. We also war with Great Britain, as you know, but they killed my transport army, so I don't like them very much anymore. But that doesn't really matter. We'll be taking some sort of revenge, one way or another, anyways. And I'll put the general in charge of that army. There we go. We are finally. Heck, we'll take the administrative cost, because that's the one we're least likely to upgrade in the near future. Boundary dispute on Dalmatia. We can press the issue here. Doesn't matter if we get into war with Hungary, really. And apparently I have a little bit too few men in all of these, or most of these siege units, thanks to the attrition. So we'll have to correct that sooner or later. But for now, destroying the this guy's armies takes interest, so to speak. But for now, I'll simply use these guys as extra siege units, because I don't really have anything else to use to mass. There we go, everything is under siege. All that remains there is simply waiting. And I am actually tempted to send these guys up north to simply cause some issues for the British. And also, we'll kill off those 10,000 Swedes that have for some reason decided to come down to Algarve of all places. They actually have a 6-6 general, which is kind of bad. I didn't have 6 maneuver 2 for the challenge, but still, I kicked his ass. He deserved it. So I'll do the same old, I guess. We'll be waiting for a big battle, for something interesting to happen. We'll most likely have to deal with Great Britain one way or another, but for now we'll be trying to hunt down their navy. This is the first time this has happened to me. Apparently I lost a claim and that ended the war. Personal union with Sweden, that doesn't even make any sense. I don't get why they suddenly ended up in a personal union with Sweden, especially since I was actually fighting for the exact same claim. It doesn't compute. But still, what should have happened is probably that I should end up in a succession war with Sweden then, instead of continuing a war for on my own here. But apparently what I am at war with now is simply Burgundy, and I'll take the money, but that's it. Also, now the only possible thing here is that I can now go ahead and release vassals once I'm done with Great Britain. So what we will be doing here is kicking. Why am I at war with Holstein again? What happened here? So Holstein actually ended up joining into this war since they got into personal union with Sweden. And basically that screwed me over. How does that even work? Still, that's not the point here. The point here is that something weird happened and suddenly I am in a very bad spot. And I kind of don't understand why I lost that claim too. That's actually the worst part of it. So we'll go for the next here, Catedral and Stock Exchange. Quite good, both of them. But still, as I said, what I don't understand is why I ended up losing there. If I simply could understand, then perhaps I wouldn't be so mad about it, but still. I think we want that guy to try and take control over these, try and fight over here. But still, it's quite annoying when things simply happens for no good reason at all, and you're simply supposed to deal with it. So I'll be fixing my armies here. I thought I had a great opportunity there to get Holstein, but apparently the fact that I were at war with them is what actually screwed me over in the end. So all in all, it's quite weird, but well, you can't win them all, I guess. Let's see here, 13, we'll put it down to 12-4-4, I think. There we go, we'll select that unit. And the other one here is how. We'll do the exact same thing to this one. And there we go. These two units are now basically done, so we'll be sending them down here, prepare for a secondary war against the Ottomans. And that should be a fun experience, I think. The only thing is that I still actually have the royal marriage with Holstein, apparently. But, yeah, since I'm in career control, I'll simply break it. It doesn't really make any sense to have it. And I have a feeling that it's kind of most likely a bug that has been addressed, or it might even be how it's supposed to be, just that I didn't get it. But still, apparently I lost that battle, and it hurt quite a lot. But still, I think I should be... No, I lost that army, actually. Wow. We'll have to sort this out later. What do you guys actually want? Nothing. Concede defeat. How about I concede? No. Concede defeat. How would you feel about that? Nope. Money. Yeah. They want a lot of money, basically, to give up here. And, well, I'm not going to give it to you. So, whiny, cry me blimey. What I will be doing, though, is giving you a present in the form of 220,000 men units coming your way, and I'll be recreating another 20,000 men unit, as well as causing some other issues, I think. So until I can get my revenge, I'll be sitting by peacefully. Military tech 17 has been reached, and with it we have the flintlock musket, which is probably why I lost that battle, since these guys already had it and had a boost to infantry fire through it. So what we will be doing here is sending two new 20,000 man units over there, trying to have them cause some serious damage. And other than that, there probably won't be too much happening. Hopefully these guys can cause their navy some losses, because, well, they deserve it in my point of view. So I'll be continuing with what I have been doing, but we'll be also creating 40,000 extra men now, simply to give them a feeling of their own medicine here. And here is the Swedes' payment. You lost all your navy in one battle. And I'll be simply be blocking in the British navy, so that should be fine. But still, I'm a little bit pissed off that Holstein actually wasn't something that I got, and instead it went to the Swedes. But apparently the British hasn't landed down any more colonies. That's a good thing. But we'll have to focus on getting Austria, most likely trying to get them integrated. And also we have to cancel the military access with Hungary. Also, I want to release these three ASAP as well, so I can start causing them some more troubles. But that'll have to wait until we're finally done with these annoying Britishmen. I also have to tell Wales to go to hell, because they haven't really been helpful at all. Also, I know I said in an earlier episode that having these armies actually just join the navy, there's actually a button up here that I didn't really see, and that is attached to transport, which basically does this. Now these guys will actually join the navy out to sea, and I feel like an idiot for not noticing that before now, but still, it's far faster than the way I've done it, so that's a good thing at least. Apparently there's a lot of rebels here that I actually haven't gotten any warning about whatsoever, but still, we'll be using this army then to deal with them. I'll probably take the 4,000 men from this to join up with these guys. And as you can see here, I'm actually building more navies, and that is simply 20 galleys that I want to add to my current setup, I guess. So Well, once I've done that, we will most likely go off the Ottomans again. I'll simply have to wait for Great Britain to get punched in the face here. I want the revenge. It would really feel good. So what we'll be doing here is drop these guys off in Yorkshire. Yeah, well, that ended horribly, I think. So, could you guys do me? No, I think I'll actually win. No, I lost. And these guys decided to run to FIFA instead of actually just going onto the damn boat. So go north then. And hopefully I can get these guys on the boat before they are maliciously ambushed by the Swedes. So let's see what actually happens. And I think I will actually win that battle. I at least hope so. We'll also drop in the extra troops. But apparently it seems that the Swedes actually are quite powerful in terms of power. They're actually just running to FIFA. So I can potentially destroy their armies there. I should at least be able to. Yes, that is that Swedish army gone. And with it, the British lose very much of their fighting power. But I'll end this war with the British, then I'll get back to you, and then we'll see what we'll do with the rest of the problems, so to speak. Great Britain can finally accept a white peace, so we'll be giving it to them. There we go. They also lost all of their troops, so I'm not even sorry. Really, they deserved it the way they acted towards me. I kind of want to say they deserved it. Also, we're losing quite a lot of cash. We'll be going army maintenance down, we'll be saving up a little bit, then we'll be going after the Ottomans again. And all in all, that should be interesting in its own right. But for now, military access from Holstein, nope. You guys screwed me over, then I will screw you over. I don't get why that the Swedes actually just got them for free. That doesn't really make sense. Especially since I'm actually at war. I guess the only reason why I actually got that problem in the first place is simply because of the fact that the Swedes had that I already was at war with them. But still, that's a very bad solution to it. Simply giving it to one of them, that basically does just put it into it simply makes it a bingo, more or less. You have to be lucky. You have to be you simply have to be lucky. There isn't any more to it than that. And we're missing one here. Where is Bulgaria? Nope, Bosnia. There we go. Yeah, Bosnia. There we are. All three vassals reborn. Nope, go away. I'm not friendly with anyone anymore. But yeah, 25,000 rebels will be a little bit of a problem here. And also, we'll have some... could potentially get some troubles with manpower. But for now, we'll be sitting by peacefully waiting for the war with Ottomans. This has simply been the worst screw-up in as far as I've been playing this game for quite a while. So I apologize because of that, but still, it's just annoying how this actually ended up working out. But I will, as I said, end up with fixing the unit, see how I make things okay again. I'm pretty sure it's time to get a little bit of update here. We're getting troops in position, 6,000 men here. 20, so about 100,000 men ready to invade the Ottoman lands. I have 20,000 guys now in over here. And also, as you can see, Wales will actually now accept a vassalization offer. So we'll most likely screw over Britain that way. Also, they haven't actually popped up any new things over here, but as expected, Norway's actually now started to create colonies as well. So potentially we need to declare war on them, but I don't have a casus belli, so we'll have to see how that turns out. But I need to kill off those guys one way or another. So the way to do that is most likely wait for this thing to core, but it will take 6 more years, so that basically means that they will finish that colony. So what I will most likely do is take Highlands, Great Britain here, core it myself, and then simply use it as a tool to attack Orkney. But for now, we'll be declaring war on the Ottomans. Show superiority, or usual way. Wales, you are going to stay up there because you screwed me over against the British, because you could simply have given up when they actually took those two provinces to begin with. But no, you wanted to fight forever. But as I said, the plan here is to attack the Ottomans. We'll be doing declaring war this episode. Unfortunately, we can't actually pull it off more than that, simply because of the fact that there aren't any much more than that to show. What we'll be doing too is most likely also going after Aragon here, just get them done. I don't care too much about aggressive expansion right now, at least not against Britain, at least not against Norway. So all in all, I want to take the Balkans, then we'll most likely go down here, try to take the some of the Mamluk lands, Egypt, so forth. Create some sort of naval base over here, and then we'll be using that to start fighting the Indian small states. That is the plan. We'll see if we can pull it off. I have no idea, but we can at least try. As you can see, the integration is coming along slowly but surely, I guess. And also, I could potentially hire a guy to help that, but apparently there wasn't one available. That's too bad. But still, we have one diplomatic relation too many, and I'm pretty sure that is actually intentional. Vassal alliance with Wales, and yeah, so it's all intentional. How long till I can start integrating you guys? 22 more years, but I actually started the integration of Austria, as you might see here. It's at 9.6%, still a long way to go though. But this is the end of this episode. Next episode we'll go after the Ottomans, and I have to say thanks to Wave for reminding me why I hate allies. And apparently the fact that they are war leader scared me even more. Because, well, that never happens to me. But still, as I said, we will be going off the Ottomans now. We have already declared war. They don't actually have that many men anymore, and they still have a fairly good war resource, and they only have a medium level of wanting to fight. So we will be taking most of the Balkans if we are lucky. Bosnia, we want actually to take that. So in terms of that, we will most likely turn on Hungary soon too. I have the claim, so what's tempting is to simply take one province here. Let's see, this one, create Croatia, hand back Bosnia and so forth, and basically just screw them over that way. But as I said, this will be the end of this episode. Thank you for watching. Please leave a comment. Praise Christmas Menting you feel like. I know I should have started a little bit more, getting a little bit more eastwards, but that's what we will be doing now. I will still keep an eye on the west though, try to keep the other nations out of the new world. We have done pretty well so far, but it will be a little more difficult once we actually have to deal with Norway here. Hopefully I can get them through a union or something. I can only hope, but we'll have to see. That Norwegian colony is kind of annoying. So once again, thank you for watching. Please leave a comment, praise, criticism, anything you feel like, you know the drill, and I'll see you next time. Bye.